network effects. Okay, network effects is the perhaps the the spine of platform businesses. Okay, this is why we talk about it. It's not because now we have technology and before we didn't. The reason why we talk about platforms today is the power of network effects. Okay, so direct network effects. Let's start with that. Direct networks network effects are same side effects. Okay, so occur when the increasing number of customers or users of a product drives an increase in value or utility for that same type of user. Okay, so we also refer to that as direct network externality, often used in economics, for example, or same side network effect. Okay, so what is a direct effect here? What is a same side network effect? Take the example of Facebook. We'll look into that a little bit more in detail later. But on Facebook, we have same side effects. We have one side that is users, okay, like you and me of Facebook. Okay, so there is a direct network effect because more there are users like me on Facebook, the higher the probability that I will find new friends or my actual offline friends on Facebook, and this means the higher the value, the utility for me to use Facebook. Okay, same side effect. It's one side, user side. I'm a user, my friends are users, and I know I can, write them messages or get in touch with them or just be up to date of what's happening in their life through Facebook. So I'm using Facebook as well because more of my friends are on Facebook, higher the value is for me. Same side effect. Okay, I hope you get this. This is a very, very important aspect. Simple example, telephone. Again, telephone is not a platform. Okay, but just to exemplify the direct network effect. Telephone, nice product, right? In the beginning, when telephones developed, if you had one telephone at home, nice. Didn't bring you any value, right? Because if you're the only one who has a telephone, you got no one to tell, no one to call. Nobody calls you. Okay, so the telephone is basically useless. So it increases in value if more users have a telephone at home or use a telephone. Okay, so this is a typical example of a direct network effect. Okay, it's basically useless if there are no other users, right? And it increases the more users there are, the higher the value of the platform or of the telephone to you. Initially, this is interesting as well, economists discussed positive direct effects. However, those effects can also be negative. Okay, so example here, and we get back to the nightclub example if you want. To avoid severe competition, men might prefer to have less other men be in a nightclub. Okay, so this is where the question in the nightclub is who is what's offered, what's demand, right? Let me get into that here. But of course, if there are more men or more people of the same gender, for example, it means more competition. Okay, and more competition is perhaps not good for you. So basically, direct network effects can be negative as well. Let's get into the second example, okay? The second type of network effects. This is indirect network effects. And this is actually where the power of multi-sided platforms actually kick in. So indirect network effects occur when an increase in the number and quality of customers on one side of the platform drives increasing value for customers on the other side of the platform. Okay, so other side. Okay, so we refer to this also as cross-site network effects. Okay, compare that to the same site network effects we had in the direct network effect. Now we talk about cross-site network effects. Okay, so when we have at least two or more distinct types of customers, it is beneficial if we talk about positive indirect network effects. It means that more there is another group another type of customers joining the platform, the more interesting it is for me to be on the platform. Example, OpenTable. Okay, so OpenTable is a tool for restaurants and visitors at the same time to book a table as a guest, book a table at a restaurant. Okay, so in how far are there indirect network effects? Because for you, as a guest, someone looking for a restaurant for tonight, once we can again go to restaurants, right? It is more interesting to go to OpenTable if there are a lot of restaurants referenced there. Okay, so the more restaurants that there are on OpenTable, the more interesting it gets for you as a guest, somebody looking for a restaurant for tonight, to go on OpenTable. Okay, on the other side, as OpenTable or as a restaurant, it is more interesting to be on OpenTable the more customers, the more potential guests are registered on OpenTable as well. Okay, so this is not same side effects. Okay, so I'm not, as a potential, if I look for a restaurant, I'm not going on OpenTable because there are other people like me going on OpenTable looking for a restaurant. I don't care. Okay, it might even be harmful because then there's more competition for perhaps limited spots at my favorite restaurant, for example. Okay, same side for the restaurant. If there are more of my competitors on the OpenTable, it's not more interesting for me to be on OpenTable. Okay, might be the case. Okay, so in order to have no competitive disadvantage, because all the others are on OpenTable but you are not, this might be another discussion, of course. Okay, but the power of OpenTable is cross-site network effect, or cross-site effect, or indirect network effect. Okay, so the more there are restaurants, the more customers or guests are potentially interested in registering and going on OpenTable. And the more there are potential guests on OpenTable, the more interesting it gets for restaurants to actually join OpenTable. Okay, of course, indirect network effects can also be negative. And an example might be ad-supported media. Okay, indirect network effects usually run only one way. Okay, think about YouTube, right? I don't know if you have an ad blocker installed on your internet browser. Okay, when I ask this question to my marketing students in other classes, usually, basically, 50, 60, sometimes 75% of hands go up. Okay, saying that many marketing students actually installed an ad blocker on their internet browser. And what those students report me or explain to me is that one of their main motivators to do so, to install an ad blocker, is to avoid ads on YouTube. Okay, because it's annoying that there are those interruptions or pre-roll ads. Okay, so this might be annoying. So at this moment, okay, there's a negative indirect network effect. Okay, meaning that the more advertisers joining YouTube, the less interesting it is for me as a viewer to actually be on YouTube, because I'm so annoyed by all those interruptions of my favorite videos there. Okay, so it might be, this is a broad discussion, another broad discussion to have here as well. Okay, but keep in mind that both network effect types can be positive and can be negative.